सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्ते नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्विधाति पूर्वं येदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तं हतिं मातुमिति प्रकाशं मुक्षुः शरणम् अहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचित् घन गणेशाय नमो। यं सुखनित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूप अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धे वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येकम्। So we looked at the Vaishnava Mata and then the Shaiva Mata, where Upasana of each deity is being said to be superior to the other in this Sabha called by the Raja. Then Ganesha Pujakasya Uttaram. So it was said that Ganesha also, even if he is worshipped first, he being Karya and Shiva being Karana, all his powers come from Shiva. This was said by the Shaiva. So the Ganesha Upasaka is saying, Ganesha Shivasya Putra Karana Gana Eva Karye Api Anuvartata Iti Etat Chrutva Kupito Ganesha Pujaka Ganesha Pujaka Pratyuvacha Edam. So Pratyuvacha Idam Uvacha. He was angered by saying that all the powers of Ganesha are Shiva's powers, and thereby he answered, Hey Rajan, Shrunu Me Vachaha, Eta Ubhavapi Mithya Bhutam Artham Satyatvena Sadayata. He says both of these, Vishnu Upasaka and Shiva Upasaka, are lying through their teeth. Yad Ganesha Shivaputraha Paradhinas Chetyuktam Tad Asangatam. Saying that Ganesha is dependent on Shiva is inappropriate, it is not right. अत्र च व्यासेन भगवता पुराणोक्ता कथा काचित् कथ्यते। सो दि पुराण कथा एज नरेटेड बाय भगवान व्यास इज मेंशन्ड हियर। त्रिपुर संहारार्थं हरिहरादयः सर्वेपि देवाः जग्मुः गणेश पूजा करणान् न त्रिपुरा पराजिताः पश्चात् भयाकुलत चित्ताः ते सर्वेपि गणेशमाराध्य त्रिपुरान् अजयन् यस्यैव गणेशस्य पूजया जयः अभूत् देवानां स एव सर्वैः सेव्य इति विज्ञायताम्। सो देयर इज अ पुराण कथा दैट ऑल द देवतास वेंट टू विन ओवर द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स बट दे कुड नॉट, सो दे हैड टू कम बैक एंड वर्शिप गणेश एंड देन गो बैक एंड विन ओवर दे वर एबल टू। देयरफॉर By whose puja they won over the three worlds, all the devatas, including Vishnu and Shiva, sa eva sarvaihi sevyaha. He should be worshipped by everyone. Yatha pitur dasharatasya manushasya ramavadra putraha abhut ishvara api san tatheva paramashivasya api ganesha putraha bhutva vignan nirachakara. So this karana being more powerful than Karya is not necessary. It's not a rule. There is no such niyama. It gives an example that Bhagwan Rama, he was Ishvara himself. He was born of Dasharatha. Dasharatha was not more powerful. It was not that all the Rama Shakti was Dasharatha Shakti. So this rule not being there, it does not apply here either, says the Ganesha Upasaka. गणेश पुराणम अपि श्री व्यास भगवान एव अकरोत्। देयर इज अ गणेश पुराण आल्सो मेड बाय सेम व्यास महर्षि। तत्र सर्वस्यापि कारणं गणेशैव इति निरूपितम्। सर्व कारणानां कारणं ईश्वर इज सेड टू बी गणेश। तस्य शुंडा दंडादेव हरिहर विधि हरिहर Vidhiravi. So Harihara Vidhi. Actually Vidhi is also the name of Brahma there. Virinchi, all these names are there. So Harihara Vidhi Ravi Shakti Pramukaha Sarvepi Devaha Ajayanta. So from his trunk all the other devatas are born. Yastu Vignesha Dhyanam. Kshanamatrami Karoti Tasya Vignaha Sarvepi Tatkshanadeva Vinashyanti. Just by a momentary dhyana of Ganesha, all vignas go away. Therefore, is called as Vignesha, Vignana Misha. Itham Aharnisham Bhaktyuktehi Vinayakaha Vignaraja Eva Nishkamataya Sevyaiti. Therefore, drop all these ideas and take to Ganesha being, Nishkama. Being Nishkama, you don't expect anything, he'll give you everything. This is the idea of the Ganesha Upasaka. Devi Bhaktasya Uttaram. So Devi has also been insulted by the Vaishnava. Now there is an answer given by the Devi Upasaka. Ganeshasya Sarvasyapi Karanamityetad Vachaha Shrutva Bhagavati Bhaktaha Sarga Sagarjanam Sagarjanam Idam Ahahe Rajan Shrudu Me Satyam Idam Vachaha. He says, I'll tell you what is the truth. He announced Sagarjanam, so he announced that I will tell you what is the truth. Trivhirapi etaihi uktam apramanam eva. There is no pramana to whatever these three people have mentioned. There is no pramana at all. They are just saying that, but there is nothing to back it. Sarvepyete devaha shakti virahitaha shapraya ityeva vidhi. He says all these without Shakti, all these devatas are going to be Shava Samana. So if you take away the Shakti, they are all insentient. The Shakti is what makes them really sentient. He is saying they are equivalent to dead bodies really. That's what he is saying. Shava Prayaha Ityo Vidhi. Shakti Virahitaha. If Shakti goes away, Shakti is Devi. So who is really the most superior has to be Devi because she is Shakti Rupa. Everyone gets Shakti because of Devi. Shakti hi naha hi asamartha ityuchyate. Kathannu tasya karya nirvahakatam karya nirvahakatvam yetavad atyantam shaktim upasate te sarvadhikarinaha bhavanti. All this adhikara also is due to Shakti. That comes only by upasana of Devi. Therefore, all these people who are mentioning this devata is greater than the other, it is all wrong because all of them have one common factor, which is Shakti, which is Devi's Swarupa. Harihara Surya Ganapati Pravrutishvapi Nana Vida Shaktiha Drishyante. You see many types of Shaktis manifest in Vishnu, Shiva, etc. Ganapati. Loke Yaya Shakti Rityuchyate Sasa Bhagavati Swarupa Eva Iti Janihi. Wherever you see any Shakti, it is Bhagavati Shakti, it is not their own Shakti. Bhagavatya Rupadvayam Asti. So, Bhagavati Devi has two Rupas, Ekam Samanyam Aparam Savishesham. So, Samanya Vishesha Bhedat, there is twofold Shakti Rupa. Sarveshu Padarteshu Tattat Kare Karananu Kula Samarthya Rupaya Shakti Sa Bhagavatya Samanyam Rupam. The general Shakti is what? That which is there in each and every Karyakarana, in all Padarthas, in which help in Karyakarana Bhava, that Shakti is, that Samarthya is Shakti which is Samanya. Ashtabhujadi Yukta Yamurtihi Sa Tasyaha Savishesham Rupam. However, when she manifests with a particular form of, when she manifests with eight hands and all that, the rupa that is discussed in the Devi Bhagavatam. That is her particular form. Samanya Shaktehe Aumshastu Sankhyatita Vartante. Samanya Aumshas are many. Yasmin Shaktyamshaha Nunaha Vartate Sa Alpa Shaktiman Asamarta Iti Uchyate. Atra Shakti Amsha Adhika Vartate Sa Samartha Ityuchyate Yatra. So yatra shakti amsha alpa, where there is this little amshas of shakti, such a person, you know, a person who has little amsha of, can be a person, can be devata. So generally we know that wherever there is one amsha of shakti, that is alpa shakti. Wherever there are more amshas of shakti, those are called as shaktiman, sarva shaktiman. All these ideas are there only based on shakti manifesting in number of amshas. If you count the number of amshas, so you'll see alpatvam and bahutvam. Thereby you know the samanya manifestation is where you see some amshas here and there. All those are devis, shakti amshas, but still all of those where there are manifestations of these small amshas, nyuna amshas, they are alpa shaktiman, asamartha. Whereas the specific form that Bhagavati takes, where padhika amshas are manifest, really purnata, so that is supposed to be sarva shakti vati, or rupam will be sarva shakti mat. So yatra shaktyamsha adhiko vartate sa samartha ityuchyate shiva vishnu adishu shaktyamsha adhikya te ati samarthaha. So we'll say that the devi form, which is a particular form, that is purna form, but when across everyone, when the shakti is manifest, they are all alpa shaktiman. But the same shakti, when it is concentrated in these devatas, Shiva, Vishnu, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, whatever you want to take it, wherever you see more, so it can be Ganesha also, wherever you see more shakti, all that is what shakti amsha adhikya being there, te ati samarthaha. So the samarthya that you see in Ganesha, Shiva, Vishnu, all these are not their samarthya. It is because of more amshas of shakti than human beings and other devatas manifest in those particular deities. Itham bhagavatyamsha rupa shaktyamsha adhikya vishnu shiva ganesha surya adishu tesha mahima prasiddha. So the mahima is prasiddha. Why? You think that it is due to their own, you know, in their puranas you read it is due to their own being superior, but it is not true. Shakti is manifest, that's all it is. So it is all bhagavati. Pranavihinam shariram yatha amangalam tatha shakti vihinaha sarve deva api amangala eva. So just like without prana the body is just a dead body, similarly and amangala also, inauspicious. You want to burn away the dead body, do away with it as soon as possible. Similarly here, devatas should not be worshipped. If you see that these devatas have the shakti, so you should go to the source. That is the idea here. They are inauspicious without the shakti. Tasmat shaktyadikya devana mahima sa mahima shakti reva natu devanam shiva vishnu adi bhir bhagavatya. So bhagavatya samanya rupa shakti visheshataha upasana tesham shaktyam shadikyam vartate. Anyway, so that's the idea there. Bhagavatya, bhagavatya nirakara rupaya shaktir yatha aneka aumshaha vartante tatha sakara rupaya shakti api aneke aumshaha vartante tadrusheju sakara aumsheju kali rupam pradhanam maheshwari vaishnavi sauri gashneshi ityadayah api pradhana aumshaha eva. So the primary forms are shakti's primary forms are also where a lot of purnata, rather purnata can be seen. This can be the assumption there. Kali rupa is pradhana, then there are others also, Maheshwari, Vaishnavi, Ityadi. Ganeshi, it should be Ganeshi, thank you. So this Gashneshi didn't make sense, but anyway, there may be something in the Purana, I can't be sure. So, thanks. Maheshwari, Vaishnavi, Sauri, Ganeshi, Ityadayaha, api pradhana amsha eva. So bhagavat upasanaya eva sve sve maheshwaradyaha amshaha taihi praptaha tatrapi shiva vishnu bhagavatya mukhyau bhaktau. So even if the shakti is manifest in many, where you see that, oh, they are all you know, Ishta Devatas, and thereby you think they are Ishwaras, but what happens is that the Ishwaratvam that you see is due to, Aishwarya is due to their being Mukhya Bhakta of Bhagavati. Dhyatuhu Dhyerupata Praptihi Upasanayaha Phalam. So what is the Phala of Upasana? The Dhyata becomes Dhyerupa, meaning the Dhyata takes the form of the, or merges even with the Upasya Devata. Shiva Vishnu Bhyam Upasana Bala Dhyerupata Labdha Atastav Mukhya Upasakau. They have merged into Devi, they have taken the Devi's form in one way or the other, therefore they are Mukhya Upasakas, who? Shiva and Vishnu. Amruta Mathenena Amruta Udbhava Samaye Surasura Vivadam Parihartum Pravruttasya Vishnoho Samartyahani Rabhut Tada Sopasya Devatam Bhagavatim Dhyatva Swayameva Tat Tadatmyam Avapa. So Vishnu lost his capabilities, all his shakti he lost, samarthya, during the Samudra Manthana. Amruta was being looked for, so he exhausted all his samarthya, then he did upasana of Bhagavati, and then tatadatmyam avapa, he merged with her. He tapped onto her shakti. Tadrupa mahatmyad asurapi Vishnu paksha patino bhavan. Tatha shivah api samadhu bhagavati dhyana balat swardha sharirena ardhanari sharirena upasya abhut. So they became upasya, Shiva and Vishnu. So Vishnu was upasya even for asuras. And then Shiva became Ardhanarishvara, therefore he became Upasya. Vishnu, by merging and tapping onto the Shakti, and Shiva by merging physically also. So Ardhanarishvara. So half of Shiva is actually Parvati. She gives the Shakti to him, and thereby he became Upasya also, says the Devi Upasaka. Vikshepa Vashat Samadhya Sampurtya Tasya Vishishtam Shariram Upasyam Nabhut. Tasya Shivasya Itham Eva Sarve Api Deva Bhagavat Upasaka Eva. So Vikshepa Vasha Samadhya Sampurtya Tasya Vishishtam Shariram Upasyam Nabhut. Shiva by himself is not Upasya, says the Devi Upasaka. He is Upasya only because of Devi taking half of his Sharira. And similarly, Itham Eva Sarve Api Deva, Sarve Api Devaha Bhagavat Upasyaka Eva. All of them who have Shakti are because they are Upasakas of Devi. All the Devatas, says the Devi Upasaka. Devi Upasana Dakshinottara Marga Abhyam Diprakara Kathyate Tatra Dakshina Marga Kathitaha Uttara Marga Itak Kathyate. So the Dakshina Marga and Uttara Marga are two ways of worshipping the Devi. Dakshina Marga has been talked about earlier in the Tantra section. Now Uttara Marga is being mentioned. Bhagavati Bhakteshu Harihara Devata Kaha Anyahasti Tadupasakaha Tatapi Mahamaya Swarupini Dhyatatu Sakalam Purushartam Shigram Eva Labhate. So although there cannot be any Upasaka like Hari and Hara, still whoever does Upasana on Devi, they get the Purushartha Siddhi without any waste of time, without losing time, Shigrata, Shigram Eva. Ekatra eva bhoga moksha prapti upayatvam na anyatra etasma devi dhyanad asti jagati. Those who do devi upasana, they are the ones who get bhukti and mukti both. Unlike other devatas who can give you one of the two. You choose one, they'll give you one. But devi upasakas get both bhoga and moksha. Bhukti, mukti, both are possible. So you are happy here as long as you are here, and when you want freedom, you are free as well. भगवती भक्तः सकलान भोगान भुञ्जानोपि पुनर्गर्भवासं न भजते. So even if you have विषय आसक्ति and you pray to Devi for bhukti also, you have want moksha also, generally it is not possible. Vedanta says it is not possible, but this Upasaka says it is possible. How? You do Devi Upasana. She will not give you Garbhavasa Dukkha. So Janma won't be there, but as long as you are here, she will give you Bhoga. Shiva Uktaha Tantra Krama Yakatitaha. So the Tantra Krama as narrated by Shiva, which is what basically Devi Upasana do. So Bhagavati Bhakti Ratyanta Sukaprada Nikhilairapi Prachinaihi Anushthita. It is not a new sampradaya, it has been there for a long time. It leads to Lord of Sukha. Therefore, Devi Bhaktas are more Sukhi than others. This is the idea that the Devi Upasaka is giving here. Panchamakaraha Kadapi Chaktum Nashakyante Shri Krishna Balaramadayaha Sarvepi Devaha Jnaninopi Prathamakaram Sada Jalava Deva Apivan. So the five makaras cannot be given up. Now five makaras are looked at in different ways. I just mentioned in passing of five makaras which the Kaula Margis follow. Nishiddha, because of being opposed to all the Vedas. But these are also the way we do the puja. So every puja has panchamakaras. Panchamakaras basically panchamahabhutas in the sattvika upasana, sattvika puja. So here it is said, Shri Krishna Balaramadayaha Sarve Api Devaha Jnanino Api Prathamakaram Sada Jalavad Deva Apivan. So they partake the first makara, here Jalavat, in the form of water. Itare Api Prachinaha Bhava Makaram Eva Asevanta. Makara Sevana Prakaraha Paramashivena Paropakaraya Kathitaha Shiva Vasanam. Shiva Vachanam Manasi Kuruvan Asmin Neva Sharire Bhoga Mokshadikam Anubhavati. So one who follows this Panchamakaras gets Sukha here and now. This has been revealed by Shiva. And it can also be done. All this is Manasika also. You can do Manasika. Shri Vyasa Bhagavan. Therefore it is an Upasana. It becomes an Upasana. Because most of this, although there is something to keep you engaged outside, it is more inward. So Shri Vyasa Bhagavan Eva Etad Bhagavatam Api Chakara. We have seen that Devi Bhagavatam is another Bhagavatam. And it is an Upapurana created by the same Vyasa Maharshi who made the other Puranas also. So Upapurane Hi Kalim Avarnayata. भगवत्या भक्तिरेव श्रेष्ठत्वेन कथ्यते सर्वेपि पूजा विधयः तेनैव कथिताः. सो दीज आर आल्सो डिस्कस्ड इन भगवती देवी भागवतम. हियर सो यू सी एतच्च देवी भागवते विस्पष्टं उपलभ्यते. हाउ टू फॉलो ऑल दिस इज देयर इन देवी भागवत. हरिहर भानु गणेशादयः भगवती ध्यानेनैव जीवन्ति. ऑल ऑफ दीज देवतास are even alive in those very forms, including their Shakti is Samartya, even to be alive is due to Devi Dhyana. Matimanta Sarvepi Prathamakara Panena Mattamana Saha Santaha Bhagavatim Pujayanti Jagajanani Sa Devi Eka Eva Sada Jagarti. So while everyone else is involved in their tasks and they may even go to sleep, Bhagavati does not go to sleep. See, she keeps awake all the time. Tat sevyaeva paramanandam anubhavati. So what has been asked, even if you recall the question of the Raja Shubhasanchati. So he had asked, who is that devata, who is upasya, who is ajagrata, Ashushupta. So he is always in Jagrat Avastha, who does not, who is Aswapnaha, who is ready to rescue the devotee all the time. So therefore here it is said, Sada Devi Eka Eva Jagarti. Surya Bhaktasya Uttaram. So Surya Bhakta answers to this now. Bhagavati Mahatmyam Shrutva Kupitaha Surya Bhakta Ittham Vacha. So Bhagavati Bhakta has insulted all the devatas. Everyone has done so. So Surya Bhakta is angered now because Surya has also been included there. It has been said Hari Hara Bhanu Surya. All these have been mentioned there. He Rajan Mama Satyam Vachaha Shrunu. He says, now you listen to my truthful words. All these people have claimed, but now let me tell you what is a fact. Nanrutam Bhavati Maduktam. Whatever I say, so it is like a Siddhi. He says that what I say will not be a lie at all. Shatasha Shapami Matantarani Papishtani Nichatamani Cha. So he says all these other matas, they are claiming the truth, but they are all papis. So they are Shapapatras basically. That's what he is saying. Sarva Loka Nindita Gunaha Sarveyapi Devi Marge Uttamatvena Kathyante. He says all these gunas which are not to be partaken, one should keep away from them. Those are praised in the Devi Marga. Atyanta Malinam Madhyam Mahapataka Karanamapi Tirtham Ityuchyate. Says that the liquor is said to be Tirtha by these Devi Upasakas. Mahapataka, it is part of Pancha Mahapataka. Such liquor is intoxication. Intoxication should be avoided. And that is considered Tirtha by these Devi Upasakas. What truth will they tell you? Mamsam cha shuddham iti. Madhya is one makara. Mamsa is another makara. They say Mamsa is shuddha. Is it shuddha? Everybody, it is dead flesh. How can it be shuddha? No flesh can be shuddha. Viparita arthavodakam shambhutantram ananushtheyam eva bauddhagamavat. So like bauddhagama, Buddhists also follow a lot of tantras. Lot more than even Hindus. So Bauddha Agama Tantra way it is set aside. Similarly, Shambhu Tantra api ananushteyam. You should not follow Shambhu Tantra also. The Kaula Marga ityadi. Sarvanushthana yogyatvena dakshina sampradayasya Shreshtatvya api yasmin sarvam manovandha bhavati tadrusha surya bhave sarva api andha eva syat. Sorry. So what he is saying is that although this Dakshina Marga which is praised, you know, sarvanushthana yogyatvena dakshina sampradayasya shreshtatvya api. Shreshtatvya means he says that let's hypothetically agree that Dakshina Marga is savior, can be followed, whereas Uttara Marga should be discarded. Even then, even if you consider that Dakshina Sampradaya Shrestha of Devi Upasana, still you have something which is available here without whom, just like the Devi Upasaka said that Shakti Vihina Sarve Api. He said Jadavat or he said Shabavat. Basically he said Shabavat. Shakti Vihina Sarve Api Devataha. Now the Surya Upasaka is saying that even Devi cannot function without Prakasha. That Prakashatmaka, which we say, you know, Chaitanya Swarupa, Prakasha Swarupa, Brahma. That kind of Surya is one who facilitates Devi also. So here it is said that Yasmin Sarv, I am not really sure of this word. Is there any word there? Sarvam Manobandha is one possibility, but Sarvam Anobandho makes no sense there. So Sarva Manobandho Bhavati. Sarvam, actually, if you take away this sarvam andha bhavati. So that's what it means actually. I'm not really sure how tadrusha surya bhave sarve api andha eva syat. So there may be typo here. If there is an errata, well and good, otherwise we get the idea. So I don't want to sit on one word and try to find out. I can't make sense out of this otherwise. So although it is the Dakshina Marga is Shrestha of Devi Upasana, still he says that without the Surya, Sarve Api, Sarvaha Api, Andha Eva Syat. This Prakasha, Swarupa Surya is who makes the Devi shine as well. Her Shakti also shines forth because of this Surya who is Prakasha Rupa. Sarvabhasaka Surya Eva, Tadabhave Sarvatra Sarvam Andhakaro Vyapnuyat, Padarthavabhasaka Tejaha Antaranyapi Suryasya Aunshabhutanyeva, Bhanu Samana Kovasti Lokasvetakari, Parahitartham Eva Asau Antarikshe Avishram Paribhramati. Another also has made an Aropa saying that Surya goes here and there. If you do Surya Upasana, you will also become Chanchala. So this Surya Upasaka is angered by that. He says that you are talking about Chanchalatvam. He says your Vishnu, Shiva, all these will not be able to see the world. They will become Andha themselves. What help will they offer you if Surya stops shining? So forget about Chanchalatvam. There will be absolutely no possibility of any other devatas doing anything. The lokas won't survive without Surya. Even science says that lokas won't survive without Surya. So how can you say that Surya Upasana should not be done? There by Bhanu Samana Kovasti Lokasya Hitakari. He is the only one who is favoring an entire loka without caring for whether or not they are doing his Upasana or not. He shines upon the on all the worlds. The entire universe he shines upon without caring for any Upasana or anything. He just helps out everyone. Therefore, he is Hitakari unlike others. Parahitartham eva aso antarikshe avishramam paribhramati. So you see, he roams around here and there. He does it for your benefit. Sarvam hi karyam kaladhinam eva sa eva ekahapi bhuta bhavya bhavishyad rupena tridha uchyate. Everything is in time, dependent on time. The same Surya, based on whom the time is calculated, he himself is Kala. Surya gatya eva sutratmataya sarva kriya kriyante anena vidhina sarvam bhanur udajayata. So he says that everything is due to Bhanu. Tat kopa sarvam bhasmi bhavet. And if Surya becomes angered, then he can burn everything. So this is what global warming is. Surya is angered. Tasya sakara nikara bhedena rupadvayam bhavati. He also has two rupas. One is sakara, which you see, Pratyaksha, Ishwara is Surya, also called as Surya Narayana elsewhere. So is Pratyaksha, that is one Rupa, Sakara Rupa. Tatra Nirakaraha Prakasha Sakala Nama Rupe Vyapya Vartate Yadevacha Vedanti Vhi Bhati Iti Shabdena Vyavahriyate Tadeva Nirakara Prakashatmakam Adityagatam Nirakara Swarupam. However, the Nirakara Swarupa is that which Vedantis call as what? Bhati. Asti Bhati Priyam. Satchidananda. Their Chit. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Jnanam is what? Prakasha Rupa. Called as Bhati. Suryaha Bhati. Chidrupena Bhati. Nirakara Suryaha Chidrupena Bhati. And the same Chaitanya pervades in the Nama Rupa also. Satchidananda, Asti Bhati Priya, and then Nama Rupa. Adhyatraya is Swarupa. Namarupa is the manifestation which is mithya. So in the Namarupa also what pervades is the same Chaitanya who is Surya himself. That is his Nirakara Rupa. Yadeva cha Vedanti bhi bhati iti shabdena vyavariyate tadeva Nirakara Prakashatmakam Adityagatam Nirakara Surukam tadeva cha Sarva Jagat Adishthanam. That Chaitanya is Sarva Jagat Adishthanam. Vedanti should not have an issue with this. But that is Surya in his Nirakara form. Tanajnana Vashadeva Jagad Rupa Vivartaha Jayate Tadrusha Nirakara Prakasha Eva Antakarana Ruttistha Pratibimba Vishishtaschet Jnanam Ityuchyate. When it is manifest in the Antakarana, it is called as Jnana, the same Chaitanya which is Surya Prakasha Nirakara. So he is the Adhishthana of the entire Prapancha. Due to Ajnana about this Surya of one's own Swarupa, really, Jagat Rupa Vivartaha Jayate. Surya without changing, Chaitanya without changing, manifest as Nama Rupatmaka Jagat. Aham Bhanur Ityantakarana Vritti Prakasha Pratibimbena Sahaiva Yada Udeti Tada Ajnana Nivritya Jagat Api Nivartate. So this Aham Brahmasmi is basically called Aham Bhanu, Aham Bhami, Swarupataha. If one has that jnana, this is what Vedanta also says, that is when the Jagat will have Nivarana as well. Suryasya Sakaram Swarupam Nirupyate. So what is the Sakara Swarupa of Surya? Pratakaliyat Tejaha, Pratakali Yattat Teja Prakashate Tadeva Sakaram Swarupam. Everything that shines forth in the morning is the Swarupa, Sakara Swarupa of Surya. Chandra Tara Di Deepadaya Api Tadamsha Bhutayeva. So when you see everything that shines, not only that Surya, Sakara Rupa is also manifest in Chandra and the other stars in the lamps, the same Surya is manifest in fire also. Nirakara Sakara Bhedavasha Surya se yad dvirupatvam. So Sakara, Nirakara and Sakara Bheda have been mentioned. Nirakara Sakara Bhedavasha Surya se yad dvirupatvam vartate tatra Nirakaram rupam eva jnyam Sakaram tu rupam jheyam. For dhyana you use Sakara, but for jnana, you use nirakara, that will lead to moksha. Etadeva rupa dvayam vedanteshu nirguna saguna bhedena dvirupam brahmetyuchyate yatra hi kalatraya api andhakara lesho api na sambhavati tad darshana matra deva sarvepi swasva karmanyarabhante sa eva vinidraha sada jagrati devaha. So really Surya is the one who is vinidraha aswapnaha. All the karmas take place in his presence. If not here, elsewhere around the world, people are working because of some form of light guiding them. That is all Surya Prakasha. Tad dhyana andhakaro vinashyati. If you do dhyana on Surya, andhakara will go away. That andhakara is tamas, tamoguna rupa. Itare deva jagrati ityetan mithya iti vidhi iti. He says this devi remains ever wakeful, that is all mithya, because Surya is the only real, even Sakara Rupa, if you see, he is the only Sakara Rupa who is doing Jagarana. There are some tippana there. Shambhu Tantra, what is Shambhu Tantra? Pamaranam Deha Vimana Nivritti Dwara Tadatiriktatma Astitva Bodhanartam Veda Anadhikarinam Kvachid Ruchyutpadana Abhiprayena Shivakritam Tantram Shivatantram Vamatantram Ityapi Uchyate. So Vamatantra Shivatantra also called as Kaula Marg elsewhere. So all that people like, basically Pamaras who do not have more capacity to understand, for them all the Stula Vyavastha is given. You do this, that itself is Panchamakara. You do what you are doing, but you know, you follow it through by offering it to the Devi, you consider it as Devi Upasana, so somehow you will come out of Tamas. That is called as Shambhu Tantra. वेदस्य अंतः समाप्ति चरम भाग सिद्धांत वेदांतः उपनिषद. सो वी नो दिस एनीवे. पूर्वोक्त मतानुवादः स्मार्तमतञ्च. सो व्हाट इज द आइडिया इन ऑल दीस डिस्प्यूटिंग पंडितास. व्हाट डू दे वांट टू रियली से. व्हाट इज द स्मार्तमत फाइनली. सो दैट इज डिस्कस हियर इन 560th आवर्त. उक्तानां उपासकानां यथा परस्पर विरुद्धाभिधायकत्वं एवमेव अन्येषामपि बहूनां पंडितानां स्वस्वबुद्ध्यनुसारतः विरुद्धाभिधायित्वम् एव. जस्ट लाइक दीस पीपल आर आर्ग्यूइंग, एवरी वन हु इज ट्राइंग टू एस्टैब्लिश द सुपीरियरिटी ऑफ देयर ओन इष्टदेवतास आर ऑल एक्चुअली इन द रॉन्ग. परस्पर विरुद्धत्वात् इवन भगवान मांडुककार सेज एवरीवन have virodha with each other. But then taihi etat na viruddhyate advaitam na viruddhyate. यद्यपि स्मार्ताः पंडिताः पूर्वोक्तासु पञ्चस्वपि देवतासु भेदबुद्धिं न कुर्वन्ति तथापि तन्मतम् अपि एतन्मत विरोध्येव. Although the smartas, so when it has been said that anyeshapi bahunam panditanam, so all smartas also included there. Smartas follow panchayatana puja. They don't consider one superior than the other. All these are equal to them. They are manifest forms, but still others are opposed to that mata also. So that mata is in contradiction to each of the matas expressed by others and individual ishtadevata upasakas. वैष्णवस्य तु इदं मतं नहि विष्णुतुल्यमस्ति देवतांतरम् इतरे सर्वेपि देवाः विष्णुभक्ता एव. विष्णोः श्रीरामकृष्ण नारायणादीनि नामानि यः तु इतरदेवतानामभिः समतया जानाति स नामापराधी स्यात्. सो व्हाट इज द वैष्णव मत कन्सिडरिंग दिस मार्तास कंक्लूजन दैट ऑल आर इक्वल. ही सेज दैट विष्णु इज द मोस्ट सुपीरियर. So these smartas who consider all as equal, including Vishnu, they are in the wrong. How so? He says that Sri Rama, Krishna, Narayana, all these are Vishnu avatars. All these are basically Vishnu's forms. So whether you consider Vishnu as Narayana's form, so Vaishnava will say in a different way. You can take one primary form and say the others are avatars. So there is even division in Vaishnava Matha. However, one who says itara devata nama bhi samataya janati, he says that the same Vishnu is called by other names, even Shiva, then he says that that person is a nama aparadhi. He has insulted Bhagavan's name. You cannot call a Bhagavan by any name. You can't do that. You have to call him as Vishnu. Ramakrishnadi namocharana phalancha na apunoti iti. एवं शिवमते अपि नैवास्ति शिवतुल्यं देवतांतरं शिवनामोच्चारण फलं विष्णुआदि नामोच्चारणे नैव लभ्यते इति. सिमिलरली आई मीन व्हाट एवर नेम हैज टू बी टेकन ओनली दैट नेम हैज टू बी टेकन दैट इज द मोस्ट सुपीरियर. अदर नेम्स आर नॉट गोइंग टू लीड यू टू द सेम रिजल्ट. दे लीड टू डिजास्टर बिकॉज ऑफ बीइंग अ नाम अपराधी. सिमिलरली शिव उपासक सेज शिवतुल्यं नास्ति देवतांतरं. There is nobody similar to Shiva. Shiva namocharana phalam Vishnuadi namocharana naiva labhyate iti. He says that what you get by Shiva nama, you will not get. You say Shiva Shiva, you will not get that phala elsewhere. With Vishnu nama, you will not get that phala. So therefore, Shiva Shiva, Shiva Shiva, keep on saying that. Itham sarvamateshupi swasopasya devata tulyam nasti devata antaram. Similarly, is a case of each and every upasaka. They consider the form and name as superior to the others. Smarte tu mate sarvepi deva samaha tasma smartam api matam purvokta panchamata viruddham eva. Smartas consider that all devatas are samaha. Therefore, the smartamata is opposed to all other matas. षट शास्त्राणां परस्पर विरोधः. नाउ द टॉपिक इज ऑफ द शास्त्र व्हिच हैव बीन लुक्ड इनटू they have paraspara virodha, they also have virodha. Just like the devatas, upasanas, they have virodha. Here, shastras have virodha. Sankhya, Patanjala, Nyaya, Vaisheshika, Purva Mimamsa, Uttara Mimamsa, Rupani, Shat Shastrani Pi, Paraspara Virudhanyeva. We have seen these six darshanas. Yataha, Sankhyamate Ishvara Nabhyupagamyate, Samadhyatmaka Yoga Apekshaam, Vinayeva Kevala Prakruti Purusha Viveka Deva Moksha Bhavati Iti Abhyupagamyate. So Sankhya, we have seen Saishvara also and Nirishvara also. Sankhya, there are two, but generally considered as Nirishvara. So this Nirishvara Sankhya says that the yoga, which is the practice of that, that is not needed. Although you consider that yoga is the practice of Sankhya, they don't accept it. This is your opinion. They say without Samadhi, without Ishvara that yogis bring in, still Mukti is possible. Kevala Prakriti Purusha Viveka, if you can differentiate between Prakriti and Purusha, that will lead to Moksha cognitively. Why do you need Samadhi? Even Vedanti says that Samadhi is not needed for Moksha, Aikya Jnana is needed. Sankhya says that Aikya Jnana, there is nothing called as Aikya Jnana, Aikya is impossible. Samadhi is not needed, we agree. What is needed then? You need Viveka. The first quality or first sadhana to moksha is Viveka. Sadhana Chatushtaya has Viveka as the first. He says Viveka is needed. What is that? Viveka between Prakriti and Purusha. That itself will lead to moksha. Patanjala means yoga. Patanjale mate ishara abhyupagamyate. Mokshasya samadhina tasmat sankhya patanjala matayor anyonyam virodha. Yoga says that without samadhi there is no moksha. Ishara is there in yoga. So sankhya and yoga have sakshat virodha. You say that it is practice of sankhya, but sankhya is, yoga is practice of sankhya, but yoga is opposed to sankhya. Sankhya is opposed to yoga. Mutual virodha is there. Nyayamate chatvari pramanani. Vaisheshikamate dve pramani. Even in pramanas, Vedanta is considered six pramanas. Vaisheshikas agree with two. Nyaya, Nayayikas agree with four. Iti anyonyam virodha. So if you look at some aspect, you can see virodha. Evam anyapi virodha vartante jidnyasunan. Jidnyasunam anapekshatatvat tatyatra na likhyante. There are other virodhas also. He is mentioned only a primary one. You can see, you know, only two pramanas versus four pramanas. Main virodha you can see. Therefore, virodha is established. Others are there, but then people may not be interested. So, they are not listed here. Puravimamsakamate ishvara moksharupam nitya sukanchan abhyupagamyate kintu karmajanyam visheshukamiva purushartha ityuchyate. Purva Mimamsakas Karmakandi say that Ishvara isn't there. There is nothing called as Ishvara. Why? Mantras themselves have the capacity to give you Adrushta and Swarga Phala, which is Sukha Rupa. Why do you need Ishvara? And there is nothing called as Nitya Sukha. Moksha Rupa is Swarga Prapti. After that you have Janma, you know, you earn Swarga again, and then you live longer and longer in Swarga. That is Sukha, that is Moksha. It is all Karma Janya. It is all Vishaya Sukha only. All Sukha is Vishaya Sukha. There is no other Sukha. That itself is Purushartha. Uttar Mimamsayam tu Ishvara Mokshascha Angi Kriyate. However, Uttar Mimamsa Vedanta accepts Ishvara and also accepts Moksha, which is Nitya. Vishaya Sukham na Purushartha Uttar Mimamsa Abhimatam Matam Eva Asmin Granthe Sputataram Uktam. So we know this. Vedanta Uttar Mimamsa is what is the goal of this Shastra also. Evam Sarvam Api Shastram Anena Virudhyate. This Vedanta, just like Smarta Mata is opposed to all other Matas because of Samata Buddhi, similar in Devatas, similarly here Uttar Mimamsa is opposed to all other Darshanas. That's why all Darshanas, whether or not Dvaita, they are Advaita. If they are not Advaita, they are Dvaita. So you don't have to say that they are Dvaita only if they talk about a particular kind of duality. We say that na advaitam dvaitam. So advaitam you can derive by saying dvaitam na vidyate yasmin tad advaitam matam. that mata where there is no dvaita at all, that is advaita. Then you say, then do you nanj? You do nanj tatpurusha of advaita and say na advaitam iti dvaitam. So that dvaitam is different. It is not what you started from. Anything other than, so it can be shunyavada also, where there is no dvaita, there is no advaita also is dvaita. Why? Na advaitam dvaitam. Is it advaita? No. Then it is dvaita. With that definition, we can say that na nanj that you have na dvaitam. Na advaitam, sorry. Na advaitam dvaitam. In that derivation, everything that is not advaita is opposed to advaita. Viruddharte. And then you say everything that is opposed, that is not advaita, is all opposed to it. So they have advaita does not have opposition with anyone because it is the truth. Truth cannot be opposed to anything. It is the underlying adhishthana for untruth also. So that kind of mata is what is. Evam sarvamapi shastram anena viruddhyate. So although it is said in this manner, we should understand the other way around. Anena virudhyate, by saying that no, you are not right. So neti neti prakriya, in that manner virudhyate. Shastrantareshu bhedavado nirupyate asmin su shastre bhedakhandana purvakam abheda eva pratipadyate ittham sakalam api shastram paraspara viruddham eva. All shastras are opposed to each other, and in the end it has been shown that in the upasana also the panchayatana puja by samabhava is viruddha to all of these. So there is a paraspara virodha, and then uttara mimamsa and everything else have paraspara virodha in that sense. Tarka drishte pitu darshanam. So there is a pita darshana of tarka drishti. He is the only one who is there. Tattva drishti has got videha mukti, then adrishti has got krama mukti, tarka drishti lives on and then has pita darshan. Lives on or it was parallel, we don't care, but then the other two stories are over. The pita and this tarka drishti putra are there. Tarka drishti has already got jnana. Pita is searching for sukha, has got vairagya but not tivra vairagya, has manda vairagya. So what happens there? So I'll just finish this this particular paragraph. Just go quickly go through it. Idrusha viruddhavada shravanena rajnyaha itopi apurva samshaya samajani. So for this Raja, who was looking for a solution, is even more confused. By this Pandita Sabha, they have managed to confuse him even further. So he wanted a solution. He has ended up with more problems than he started with. Sarvepi hi yukti pramanopetam eva kathayanti iti. He says everyone is using yukti. There is no fact there. There is no pramana really. Em vadatam kasya matam pramanikam yathartha bhutam cheti. He is not sure as to what is right among all these statements. Etadrusha samshaya shoka dukkhadayavishtasya rajnya manasi upasya daivam idam eva iti nischaya nabhut. The conclusion that he was looking for, this is the devata who is upasya, that did not take place. Etat samshaya nivartaka kovasti iti chinta kulo jataha. He was still thinking and was worried as to who will answer this question. How is it that I'll conclude this thinking? Asmin avasare tarka drishtir yadrichhaya pitridarshanaya tadantikam ajagama. So maybe tarka drishti had siddhis also. He has studied all this, and then we see that he is roaming around, and he has also inquired of other vidwans whether his conclusion is right. Yadrichhaya is with his own ichcha, or it can also be by fate. Both meanings apply. So you can read into siddhi or just, you know, happenstance. He came and visited his father. Tauhavapi parasparam alingatu. Tarka drishti putraha pitaram yathavidhi prananama. So because he is the father, so they hugged each other, and then tarka drishti fell at pita's feet. Pita api putrashaya shishaha krutva asanam adat. And father also looking at tarka drishti, he would have got a sense of since he knew that he had gone out for jnana, so he also did satkara and gave him a good seat to sit on. Then what happened, we'll see in the next part. We'll consider tarka drishti krutaha pitu pitru upadeshaha. So he made upadesha to pita, who was thoroughly confused now, which is the reason that tarka drishti has arrived there. Karana swarupam upasyam na karya swarupam. So we'll see that what is upasya. He will say that karana should be upasya, not karya. All these people have talked about karya, which is upasya. That is wrong. Every one of these are, each and every one of these pandits are wrong. What upasana should you do? You should do nirguna upasana, the karana. So we'll see that in the next part. Sukanityam saprakasham vyapakam nam rupe adhishthanam buddhya bhuti अपारं संवेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परमो तदेव अनुमत्तो निश्चितावतिः ओम तत्सत् नमस्ते
नमस्ते
शब्दावपमानं तद्विवरणं प्रत्यक्षं कस्यचित्